डॉक्टर पी के जोशी, डॉक्टर आर बी, सीनियर कलीग्स एंड फ्रेंड्स, पॉलीकैप इज ए कॉन्सेप्ट एंड आफ्टर वी गेट द कॉन्सेप्ट राइट आई थिंक एप्लीकेशन ऑफ इट इज सिंपल बिकॉज इट इज सपोज टू बी सिंपल एंड इट कैन बी इजीली अप्लाइड टू द मासेस. It's a concept like this slide. If you think it could be a smoke of the cigarette or Ganapati, depends on what you are looking at and what you take home. The scope of the talk is about 20 minutes and what is the polypill concept. We'll see how what were the challenges and then the two trials, the TIPS 1 and TIPS 2. Then does the polycap fit the bill? What WHO wants as a polypill? Is this polycap the pill that we are looking at? Then some of my personal thoughts. I was one of the principal investigators for TIPS 1 and TIPS 2, so I have some personal thoughts I'll share with you. And I feel it's, as Dr. Joshi said, it's a social pill. If you want to reduce the cardiovascular burden of the entire society, the risk factors by large which are there in the society need to be reduced. That will reduce the CV burden and the health expenditure. So that kind of a pill is this. And of course, if at all, there could be some future projections. I have shown this slide in many of my talks, but I still feel it's one of the great slides of from scientific side. On the x-axis, you have affluence, urbanization, education. And on the y-axis, you have hypertension, lipids, diabetes, cardiovascular disease, and all the risk factors that we know of. So as this goes on increasing, this burden also goes on increasing. And India urban, we are here. So in the next 20 years or so, we are going to reach the summit. So all of us have a personal responsibility of looking after ourselves by controlling our own risk factors and at the same time trying to control the society's burden of all these illnesses so that, like the Europe, North America, Australia, New Zealand, the developed countries, they've been through the summit and they're on the way down. The other day I met an interventional cardiologist from USA and he was saying that there's not much of angioplasties or bypass surgeries increasing in USA because the ischemic heart disease is going down. Everybody is on a statin, everybody takes aspirin, people are aware of cholesterol, they do lunchtime jogging, hardly anybody smokes, and that's why overall incidence of ischemic heart disease is going down. We are, of course, on the upswing here because we are developing. But for us personally and for families, our society, or the patients that we treat, I think we can start a downward journey from today itself if we have not started. And we have a big tool with us today now, and that is the polycap. Interheart was a great study done amongst Indians, and it showed that 90% of the myocardial infarctions are explained on the traditional risk factors. Only 10% are the ones who do not have traditional risk factors. So if we do well in these traditional risk factor zone like the diabetes, hypertension, smoking, cholesterol, then we are doing a great job for the society. Unfortunately, the 10% gets discussed a lot, that somebody did not have any risk factor yet he suffered a myocardial infarction. We have to talk of the masses, think of the bigger risk factors and do well with them. And that's why this pill becomes important. Whether it is the urban population, you can see that high income group to low income group, only 60% of the white bar, that is statins, would be given to hardly 60% of the higher income group. In lower income group, hardly anybody gets statins. The blue bar, beta blockers are there, antiplatelet agents are there. And in the rural population as well, if you see, hardly anybody, so not enough people are getting the drugs that they need to take because these are the preventive drugs, and since the science hasn't percolated or we are not thinking in terms of prevention probably, we don't adequately prescribe these drugs because the doctors probably themselves do not have the conviction to give it to the society. We all know that Professor Nicholas Wald put forth a theory of polypill, I think in 2003. And he said that if aspirin reduces so many incidences, if ASCOT trial that the statins reduce so much, then if the HOPE trial, like a simvastatin reduces so much, If all this put together, hypothetically, if they are given to a patient, then we can reduce the incidence by 85%. All population above the age of 55 takes a poly pill, then the cardiovascular burden can go down as low as 15%. That's what his hypothesis. But an Indian brain who is actually functioning from Canada, Salim Yusuf in 2002 had said that if these are already data published about aspirin, about beta blockers, lipid lowerings, ACE inhibitor, combined effect, then if they are combined well and put together to the society, then we are going to reduce a large number of events. And this concept was then captured into the Polycap. So this is how two cups were to be filled up, and somebody thought of a great idea of putting the two things together, and the concept of Polycap got realized. Compliance, of course, is a big issue. If you prescribe five such tablets to somebody who is practically asymptomatic, he's not going to take the five tablets at all, and the cost of five separate tablets is going to be high. So if you use generics, put them together in a capsule, make it compliant, then the road for compliance becomes easy. And that is how the TIPS to secure life it is called, because the trial was called as a TIPS trial, which did this Polycap. The developmental milestones were 2003 or 4, literature review and new product development work started till 2013. Now the TIPS 3 trial is recruiting more than 1,000 patients in many countries, actually. So this whole journey is of developing the Polycap and then, of course, improving on it. So it's a one capsule with multiple drugs, which will have three antihypertensive drugs in the form of hydrochlorothiazide, atenolol 50 milligrams, ramipril 5, simvastatin 20 milligrams, and aspirin 100 milligrams. So why these formulations and why these drugs will be discussed definitely. But obviously, these are the ones who have proven. Aspirin is proven, ramipril is proven. Antihypertensive effects, whichever way you lower the blood pressure, I think it is already proven. So if you combine three antihypertensives with reasonable doses, then you are going to reduce the blood pressure as well. So these are all proven facts. The challenge was to put them together in one capsule. All five powders put together may not be very stable pharmacologically. There were doubts whether if aspirin will lose its potency, whether antihypertensive drugs will lose its potency. Combining one or two drugs may be easy, but combining five together, it has not been done in the world. It is done here in India by Cadila, so that's why we should feel proud about it. And the entire Polycap, the whole basis of study was to see if the five put together in a capsule, are they as effective as the individual drugs? That is where the trial lied. So was it just merely adding one to the other? No, it wasn't, because it was pharmacological stability, pharmacological analysis, bioavailability of the drugs when given as a Polycap versus those given individually, the efficacy, whether it is we are losing efficacy of the drugs, drug interactions, safety, all these factors were to be considered. I won't go into the study design too much, but it was an extensive study. There were 9 arms, more than 200 patients in each. And each one had, like, somebody was only on aspirin, somebody was on whole Folicap, somebody was only on ramipril. So all these, if you see, some allocations were like this: aspirin alone, simvastatin alone, two drugs together, three drugs together, and finally the Polycap. So now we are going to compare how the effect of aspirin alone was with the Polycap. So that is aspirin losing its effect when combined into the Polycap. That was the TIPS trial. And if you see the side effect profile, everything, efficacy, all the trials proved that none lost its efficacy. None was a problem in the pharmacological stability. Though Pune Hospital contribution for this was significant, as I said, I was one of the PIs. We had 74 patients screened and 71 were randomized, and these were the distribution, and we were among the fifth highest recruiters of the country, so a significant contribution to the trial itself. The TIPS 2 trial, which was actually double the dose, in fact, two Polycaps were used, and to find out if what was happening. Additionally, they were given potassium supplements, because then you are talking of 25 milligrams of hydrochlorothiazide given to the patient. And that also followed up for 12 weeks, seeing again the efficacy, side effect profile, what happens to the hyperglycemia and stuff like that. In summary, Polycap is a late stage near to market opportunity which addresses the largest disease market in the world. Polycap has shown efficacy and safety in two large randomized patient trials. Market trends show increased use and acceptance of combination drugs in cardiovascular disease. Very encouraging communication with US FDA. We are on the verge of getting accepted by the US FDA. The biggest advantage is that improved compliance of both physicians and patients, decreased cost, increased access to non-physicians. It can be maybe an OTC one day, it could be one of the dreams. And a basis of promoting a prudent lifestyle. Like if you really convince the patient that, look, you have a pill which can prevent a lot of things for you, and all that you have to do is do your best. So probably it is easier to motivate people to lead a better life rather than giving them six drugs and trying then again to tell them to lead a better life. And a potential large reduction in cardiovascular illnesses. Some loud thinking about it is that individual drug compounds, we know aspirin works, we know ramipril works, we know beta blocker works in preventing certain things. So there is no doubt about this part. The hypertension, lipids, heart rate also leads to mortality, higher heart rate. So that aspect also is known. Cross risk factors commonly coexist. We know that most of the time the patients may have multiple risk factors. And secondary prevention would mean that our prescriptions run five drugs, six drugs, or sometimes more than these drugs, Thinking was, can one polypill pack five drugs? The answer now is yes. Can all five drugs remain pharmacologically stable in one capsule? The answer is yes. Why combinations are cheaper than individual drugs? Because individual packaging, individual marketing doesn't take place. So that's why they are cheaper. Like five drugs, if you prescribe separately, it would cost about 34 rupees. And here we are talking of a polypill, which is about 15 or 16. That much advantage is given. And can moderate dose have the desired effect? The answer again is yes. Look at my own prescription of patient who had undergone an angioplasty. Should be aspirin, clopidogrel, ramipril, atorvastatin, metoprolol, and nitrate. This was at discharge. And the prescription almost looked like this. You don't know which wire is going which way and getting entangled. And finally, when she came for follow-up of a certain period, I changed her to one polycap and clopidogrel, which was not there in the polycap preparation. So the prescription became concise. It was easier to do the compliance part of it very well. There are obvious drawbacks that it can be an overkill. Somebody's a plain hypertensive at the age of 45. You're giving aspirin, you're giving statin. It could be an overkill for him, but you could choose a better patient than that. One would doubt why atenolol hydrochlorides are, what happens to the diabetes. This has been discussed in the doses that we use, probably doesn't affect much. Motivation in normal individuals, can it be used for a primary prevention? Probably tough because there are three antihypertensive agents in it. Fixed dose combination have its their own disadvantages because you can't increase or decrease the individual doses. Lack of compliance can be more dangerous, like somebody doesn't take the pill for 4 days, he's not taking five drugs for 4 days. So it is that kind of a compliance loss could be dangerous to the patient. And long-term trials would be required to think about long-term outcome data related to Polycap. What are the hypertensive individuals who are suitable patients for Polycap? Hypertension with few added risk factors, like somebody who has diabetes, chews tobacco, is obese, maybe he has just major one risk factor, but he is a candidate who needs more protection. Post angioplasty for some months of year, after some months or year when the separate dosing of aspirin, clopidogrel is over, and then you can probably combine it. Post bypass patients could be ideal for this. Hypertensive after 50 years of age, when you addition of statin and aspirin is required for somebody hypertensive above the age of 50. Look at this farmer who came to me, he's about 51, he chews tobacco, he's centrally obese, but the only risk factor we know is hypertension. So if you give him just a hypertensive pill, maybe after some years he's bound to develop some cardiovascular event. He's a classic patient for a polypill because he's non-compliant, uneducated, unlikely to take 5 pills just for prevention. Give him 1 pill and probably you do the job of protecting the society of the cardiovascular burden. Another patient of mine, she's come after 10 months follow-up, has an angioplasty in 2012, now has a negative stress test. So after 1 year of angioplasty, the front page looks like this, just the polycarb, because now I don't have to give her aspirin. I stopped clopidogrel after 1 year for all angioplasties. So that is where only one tablet and it is one capsule and it's the job is done. This is the prescription which is as late as September 2013. And we know this particular famous study in which it was shown that if you give these 4 drugs like the beta blocker, ACE inhibitor, aspirin and statin, then you are doing a remarkable job for all myocardial infarction patients. Their risk of reinfarction and other things become very low. This is a very famous study. So this whole principle is utilized in polycap also. And one of my patients may be diabetic, hypertension, probable angina, and not angiographed, or angiography is just introduced yet, but the prescription is a polycap and additional anginal cover for her, and maybe fashion nowadays of giving vitamin D is also included in this. So future directions are several small trials are ongoing in various countries, formulation with and without aspirin to understand sometimes statin can be removed, different form of statin can be used. The polypill will force us to rethink our approach to prevention globally. And when you want to apply something to the masses, the public transport is better than individual cars. So this kind of a concept is here, that you apply it for the masses, give it to more and more patients so that the entire cardiovascular burden of the society comes down. Future projection is large post-marketing studies, alternative antihypertensives other than atenolol and hydrochlorothiazide, where they can be used or combined or incorporated into this polycap. Or alternative statin instead of simvastatin, can we use some modern day statin that is also being thought of. Editorial comments of Lancet from 2009 states that polycap is one step towards realizing dream of global health because you're preventing large number of risk factors or secondary prevention for that matter. Such individuals with one risk factors are increasing. They may change more potent statin, good tolerability and significant issue because there are 5 drugs which are given. One risk factor got treated for all and yet was well tolerated, therefore strengthens the principle of polypill. And the major appeal is the simplicity, the low cost and the improved compliance. The final thoughts about polypill are that it's exceptionally good for secondary prevention. If somebody has an MI vascular event, giving 5 captopril separately. Exceptionally good for multiple risk factors for primary prevention. Very good to reduce pill burden. It's too potent a pill for primary prevention, but yet in certain individuals, as I said, a farmer, tobacco chewer, hypertensive, I would certainly prescribe it for him. It's reasonably good because of ease and simplicity of a single or 2 risk factors. Now, if we look at these 2 gentlemen, he's an IT professional of 38 years, and of course you know him, BK Iyengar, of 88 years of age. Lifestyles are very bad. We know how ulti people's lifestyle is. And you look at their carotid intima media thickening. CIMT ratio is 0.84, 0.58. Intima is thin, media is thick. Intima is thick, media is not so thick. So this is premature atherosclerosis, in fact. So if you look at their vascular ages, not the biological ages, in fact, they are the other way around. So can he improve his lifestyle? Extremely tough. You tell him anything, he will get convinced for a day or two, but still go back to what he is doing and will get into a problem in the next 2 years or 3. Can you prevent his premature atherosclerosis? Probably yes. The answer is with you. And probably if you apply it well, polycap can be certainly a boon for such an individual also because you are preventing many of his risk factors. So this is a photograph of Tendulkar walking out to bat on the last day, his last innings on day 2 of the test match. And for the first time, he had this tricolor on his handle of his bat. So it gives you a glow in your chest that for the first time, this great man had this tricolor on the handle of the bat. And I am happy with this because this photograph comes from my own mobile phone. I was there watching him go and in the Wankhede Stadium. So this Polycap has similar appeal, should have similar appeal to all of us. It's a great concept, put packed into a capsule. If understood well, understand the spirit behind the Polycap and probably apply it to the masses, we would be doing wonders for ourselves, for the society, and of course for the nation. It was asked to Salim Yusuf by somebody in the press conference of release of Polycap, whether this is a pill for the developing countries. He says, no, it is a pill for smart countries, because that is how you prevent cardiovascular burden. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Hiremath. Friends, you must give him a big applause for the way he explained the concept of polypill and its role in prevention of cardiovascular disease in the masses. And if there are any questions, I think they would be welcome. And even Dr. P.K. Joshi also would like to take questions. So all of us will be here. If there are any questions, let us know.
I do have beta blocker. Actually, it will increase the chances of diabetes.
Yeah, that's all if you use a single drug, but we are also giving ramipril. So, ramipril is known to decrease, isn't it? So in a polypill, we have got some things are balanced by some other drugs, definitely.
And 12.5 of hydrochlorothiazide doesn't lead to any hyperglycemia. If you go higher doses, 50 and all that, all the other things were related to that. Secondly, obviously there are some drawbacks here. And if you know, even statins can increase diabetes, and you've heard of it. But what is the guideline for statin? That the effect is so overwhelmingly good that a minor increase in the diabetes is to be accepted. It's similar to that, that there might be somebody who might get developed, withdraw after that or change after that, yes. But because of that, don't get deterred to apply it for the people who really deserve the pill.
Medications for the control of blood pressure. So in a diabetic person has suffered from myocardial infarction, we are going to give him beta blockers for angina, and you are going to give him small dose diuretic for control of blood pressure if required. So similarly, they are going to be beneficial for prevention of cardiovascular side effects.
UKPDS, the maximum benefit of mortality is because of beta blockers. So in diabetics, it is used very well, in fact, for that matter. So.
And whatever rise in sugar you get, it is very marginal, and that too for the little initial phase, later on it usually settles down. That was the long-term observation has shown. Frankly, becoming over-diabetic for a long time is not there much with statins.
No, the question is whether it can be given to asthmatics. The answer is no. Like we cannot give atenolol to asthmatics otherwise, similarly it cannot be given. Contraindications for individual drugs definitely hold true in contraindication for Polycap as well.
Some people also argue that we are giving a smaller dose of atenolol, and atenolol is more specific beta 1. At a lower dose, but when the dose increased to 100 milligrams and more, then it becomes non-specific. So at a lower dose, that what problem you have got in mind is may cause bronchospasms, because we have seen some patients were taking and they are not suffering at a lower dose, but moment doses increase, the bronchospasm increases. It is more dose related rather than, so we are going for a smaller dose, okay, but not two polycaps, one person, the number of persons suffering with asthma, increased dose definitely can cause incidence more.
Yeah. Good evening, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah. Considering different medicines, what will be the ideal timing of the tablet? Because since the diuretic is there, the statins are well at the bedtime. So.
Actually, a dose of 12.5 of hydrochlorothiazide ceases to be a diuretic after about a week or so. So my choice, actually, for the TIPS trial, there was no such, shall we say, guideline as to when to give that. Each one gave their own timing. But according to me, the best time to give it is in the evening or at night, because that's the time simvastatin acts its best. And one of the best preventive drugs that we have in this is simvastatin. So my choice would be to give it at night and explain the patient that for first few days he might feel little excess diuresis at night, but then it settles down and comfortably, even in other preparations, smaller, because you are using smaller dose of diuretics, there's no problem in giving at night, especially after a few weeks time, the diuretic effect goes away.
But most of these medications have a 24 hours effect. Atenolol effect lasts for 24 hours, and even ramipril we give once a day. So they can be given at any time of the day. If patient finds it convenient in the morning, you can very well give it in the morning. For simvastatin, you want to give it in the night.
About the drawbacks, I always keep saying that the marriage has already taken place. So now you cannot complain about the squint that the bridegroom has or something. So it is to be accepted. And it's also like if you have ST bus, it cannot be an air-conditioned bus, isn't it? So there is going to be some frictions here and there. But the concept and the spirit is correct. And the affordability is very correct. And that what it can achieve by applying it to masses is phenomenal. So that is what we should try to understand.
That is the very key factor. Okay, just giving one pill, secondary prevention or secondary event rate drops by 60%. It is phenomenal. Any more questions? I thought you will be having lots of questions about all the drugs. I will ask you one question. What do you see as a future? I mean, suppose you are told to make a ponypill in future. Would you like to change certain drugs or would you like to select some other statin?
Yeah, all these things are already being thought of, or changing to a different beta blocker, changing to a different diuretic, changing to a different statin. But all these are also fraught with difficulties of making them stable in the combination. This combination has worked because the powder is remaining stable. They are not interacting with each other. They are not losing potency. So whatever we think of a future development or betterment of the polycap has to be addressed by whether that combination is going to remain stable or not.
Do you think that two different strengths of polycap should be available?
Yes, once, as it happens with so many other combinations, once a particular concept sells very well, gets accepted by the treating doctors finally, because for the pharma industry, we are the consumers actually, not the patients. So once it is accepted, all the, combinations and formulations will come into play by a half dose or a double strength, which is already tried, or maybe four drugs or maybe some other addition or deletion. In this, actually, B12 was also thought of as additional this thing, but homocysteine, probably folic acid, was thought of, but it was dropped because of various reasons. The homocysteine theory that time got dropped off very badly, and that's why that was not included. Even, in fact, the way aspirin works also was studied through its urine analysis. And a person taking only aspirin, his urine analysis versus polycap's urine analysis showed the same amount of some substance, thromboxane 80 or something excreted. So it showed that in combination it was not a problem. I think a lot of pharmacodynamic studies were also carried out, but which were not part of the trial. They were carried out as additional books. They all proved to be quite good, though they are not published because not being a part of the trial.
It was seen that when the patient gets well, he goes back to his family doctors, and then inadvertently sometime some drugs are dropped and his prevention becomes incomplete. That thing certainly we can prevent by giving a polypill. Only one tablet he has to take and all ingredients remain there.
So it's a compliance of the patients and compliance of the doctors as well. Sometimes when you have had a fight at home, you tend to write the fifth, forget the fifth drug actually. So that also will get avoided.
We'll reduce our time of writing prescriptions and maybe we'll change of handwriting and, you know, errors in prescribing by writing.
The prescriptions of doctor have been studied all over India and they have only found that about 20% are having complete things coverage properly. Almost whooping 80% are missing out on one or the other drug.
And just because we are sitting here, it's not for that reason we are talking good about the Polycap, because probably we talk good about it and that's why we are here, I think.
If there are no questions.
Okay. Sir, will it cause hypokalemia in long-term use?
I think there's a pill contains ramipril as well as hydrochlorothiazide. So hydrochlorothiazide 12.5 usually doesn't cause that hypokalemia, and ramipril usually causes some rise in potassium. So the combination of ramipril and hydrochlorothiazide will probably balance each other, and there will not be a significant hypokalemia in these patients, as against patients whom you are giving isolated hydrochlorothiazide in a higher dose. So this should not cause significant hypokalemia.
What is your observation in trials?
There was no hypokalemia at all in the TIPS 1 trial. And TIPS 2, it was anticipated. Then because we are giving double dose, so people were getting 25 milligrams of hydrochlorothiazide. Their potassium supplement was given in addition to the two Polycaps.
Patient is put on Polycap and you monitor the targets of blood pressure, lipids and maybe other parameters. And if you are not achieving the targets, you can add other antihypertensive. Maybe an amlodipine can be added to control his blood pressure. So ultimately, when you prescribe polypill, Polycap, that doesn't mean you should not give any other medication. You must monitor his blood pressure targets and his maybe a cholesterol targets.
That's why I showed you my own prescriptions. Like I thought anti-angiogenal cover was required, so I added ranolazine to Polycap. So these things are possible. Finally, you are reducing a great pill burden. You have defined your own set of prescription, and whatever is remaining, you can always add.
Somebody's lipids are not up to mark. We have to treat to target level exactly for a good. We can even increase dose of simvastatin there. You can give extra simvastatin.
And actually, all of us are using more of atorvastatin now, rosuvastatin as a statin. The most studied statin or the most documented statin still is simvastatin. It is. Forest trial is now almost 10 years old and it continues to show the same benefit. So in the most scientific world, you will find simvastatin. If you see some prescriptions of American doctors, they still write very much simvastatin because they...
More than 4,000 patients.
Correct. So they Forest was a very large trial. It's now 10 years follow-up. And they write simvastatin because they follow rules and guidelines and they are scared of the law.
So if there are no more questions, I think we can conclude. Friends, you must give a big applause to Dr. Jagdish Hiremath and Dr. P.K. Joshi for the excellent oratory skills they have shown and the questions they have answered. With this, I'll conclude and hand over the mic to the organizer.